Prime Minister Theresa May has called for a general election, and this has caused a stir in politics across the country. She had previously stated that the next general election, which was not scheduled until 2020, will not be held until 2020. Latest TV News caught up with Peter Kyle, Labour MP for Hove and Portslade, in his campaign office to hear his thoughts on why this election was called.
Of course we shouldn't be having this general election. I mean, I had a flash of anger when I heard this was happening, not because of me, but because of the voters, what they're being put through. You know, this is a government which legislated to have elections every 5 years. They felt so strongly about it, they put it into legislation, they put it into law. Theresa May has said 12 times that we're not going to have the election until 2020. She said it 2 weeks ago. So for her to suddenly come out and say it now is saying one thing loud and clear. They're putting the party interests ahead of the country interests. And for me, that is completely unacceptable. They're dragging a party through a third nationwide election in 3 years simply because they think they're ahead in the polls. And I think that actually that will come back to bite them on the backside, to be frank, because I don't see the public putting up with this.
With those strong opinions over the upcoming elections, we asked just how confident he feels of retaining his seat.
I just don't think like that, and it's going to sound like a politician's answer, but I don't... I just don't think in terms of being confident or not. All I do is... I think every day in this job is a privilege. I thought every day as a candidate was a privilege. I wake up in the morning and think, what can I do today to make life better for the people who elected me? And if I go to bed in the evening and I don't think I've given it 100%, then I really beat myself up about it. You know, I get really anxious that, you know, I spent too long doing this when I should have been doing that and so forth. So I don't think in terms of confident. All I think of is, can I do 100% today for the people who elected me? And then when I get to the election, if I win, then fantastic. I get the privilege of being able to do it for longer. If I don't get elected, then at least I'll be able to walk away with my head held high, knowing I did give it everything I've got.
He says he does not operate with confidence in mind, but his track record has proven him to be diligent and unlikely to back down from the challenges, especially the deficit Labour currently faces in the polls, an issue Labour leader Jeremy Corbyn believes can be overturned.
Well, you're talking to a Member of Parliament who beat a Tory in 2015 when there were only 10 Labour MPs that did that in the whole country. So that means when people say to me it can't be done or the mountain to climb is too high, I heard that day in, day out for 2 years when I was a candidate. Nothing is impossible in elections. Nothing is impossible. There is nothing inevitable about defeat in politics, and there is nothing inevitable about victory. What needs to happen is, as I say, lots of listening, lots of responding, and we still have time as a Labour Party to show and demonstrate to the people, to voters, to residents, we're on their side. We exist to serve them. And that's what I'm looking for from Jeremy in the next 6 to 7 weeks.
For latest TV news, Matthew Enderby.